Canada has changed under Justin Trudeau. And I don't just mean solely in terms of the quantifiable metrics like inflation, the affordability crisis, credit downgrades, slipping transparency ratings. I mean on a far more fundamental and quintessential level. Trudeau has made no bones about it. He wants Canada to be a post-national state instead of a country that the world looks up to. He doesn't want us to be a country at all. He wants to strip our identity. The world looks at us differently now. Canada is no longer a nation of peacekeepers and truth speakers who decries injustice and is listened to and respected the world over. We are sadly now, in the eyes of much of the world, a country being led by a petulant child in fun socks who admires basic dictatorships.
There's a level of admiration I actually have for China. Because their basic dictatorship is allowing them to actually turn their economy around on a dime and say, we need to go green as fast as we...
And locks up pastors and Métis grandmothers when they dare challenge him.
A prime minister who openly admires the Chinese basic dictatorship, who tramples on fundamental rights by persecuting and criminalizing his own citizens as terrorists, just because they dared to stand up to his perverted concept of democracy, should not be allowed to speak in this house at all. Mr. Trudeau, you are a disgrace for any democracy. Please spare us your presence. Thank you.
Make no mistake about it, Justin Trudeau and his Lebrano posse don't get the final say on Canadian identity when it comes to the global stage, but they are leading us in a downward spiral that will be difficult to escape. It will be a heroic effort for an individual or a group of individuals to reclaim Canada's identity and to put us back on track as leaders in this world. But who, we might ask, is up for that daunting task? Adam Sosa here for Rebel News, and we are on location at the Canadians for Truth event, Fire and Ice. It's a live show featuring Olympians and Canadian heroes, Jamie Sully and Theron Fleury. They will be joined by Tamara Leach, a proud Alberta and Saskatchewanite, a proud Métis woman, and a proud Canadian who became an enemy of the state when she dared to organize in defiance of Justin Trudeau and his COVID-19 overreach and take on a fundamental role in the Freedom Convoy. We're going to be speaking with folks here, many of whom view her as a true Canadian hero. Joined here now by Eva Chipiak, part of the legal counsel, working with Tamara Leach and working with the Freedom Convoy. People will very likely also recognize you from the Public Order Emergency Commission. Your exceptional work there.
My last question, Mr. Prime Minister, when did you and your government start to become so afraid of your own citizens?
That's a very unfair.
I am not, and we are not.
Those are my questions.
You were kind of there at the onset. You, along with Keith Wilson, learned probably very early on that Tamara Leach had been arrested. In the face of all this adversity and in the face of all these attacks, she stood bravely and has very much become a Canadian hero. What's it like for you to see her from that early days in the jail cell to this, all these people gathering, rallying behind her as a Canadian hero?
Yeah, well, it's not at all surprising, I have to say, because there's a reason that Tamara and Chris and the people that are recognized rose to recognition, because they honestly are good Canadian people that wanted to do good for their country. They really stepped up when they were needed. They were selfless, and that is why people connected with them. They didn't, I can guarantee you, nobody asked to be in the spotlight like this. This is not easy for anyone to be doing what Tamara is doing, for example. It doesn't surprise me that she still has so many people rallying behind her, because that was what I saw in Ottawa.
And we got this. I mean, I said it every day. Good will always win, God will always win, and love will always conquer evil. And it might be a rough road for a little while, but I think we just proved that we could do it. Yeah. You know, we just drove across the country in the winter, Canada, in the wintertime, and stayed in Ottawa for 3 weeks. Like, I said to Chris on the way, the next time we do this, let's go in July. But if that isn't Canadian, I mean, I don't know what else is, you know?
Yeah.
Very fortunate now to be joined by WWE Hall of Famer Diana Hart. There's the ring. There's the ring.
He's trying to get off the hook now.
King, take it away.
What?
Well, I guess we know who wears the pants in the Smith family.
One of the themes that sort of came up a lot tonight that we've talked about with some of the other folks is heroism, representing Canada on that global stage under Justin Trudeau. We've very much seen the Canadian identity that you sort of represented on that global stage attacked. But how meaningful is it to have someone like Tamara Leach, to have so much of that grit and perseverance that's common to wrestlers in many senses, taking that fight and standing up for Canadian identity?
Oh, she's absolutely the clear-cut case of good, being Tamara is so good versus evil. Honestly, it's like a wrestling storyline that she's small but mighty, and she represents the heart of Canadians. And I feel, I heard Theo Fleury say this tonight, but Trudeau has ripped the heart out of Canada, and I feel like Tamara and the Freedom Convoy put the heart back into Canadians. If you're thinking of it wrestling-wise, like every foreign object they could bring out of their tights, you know, throw salt, you know, we're going to pay the referee off, we're going to, you know, hit them with the brass knuckles and then give them to somebody that, you know, unsuspect, like everyone from the media to the federal government, the police, it just seemed like the majority of them were not with Canadians. And the thing is, they're supposed to represent us. They're not supposed to represent corporations or big companies. They're supposed to represent their people. And that's what Tamara and the Freedom Convoy was all about. They represented everybody. It didn't matter what race, what religion, what part of the country you came from, what your income bracket was. It didn't matter about any of that. It brought everybody in Canada together.
I'm joined now by Derek Smith, author of How the Prime Minister Stole Freedom. We're talking about with Tamara Leach here tonight, just the notion of sort of heroism, modern heroism, how in the face of all of Justin Trudeau's attacks on fundamentally Canadian principles, she sort of stood out as a hero. But with the book that you worked on, with some of your perspective, just how much do you feel that Justin Trudeau has undermined, or at least attempted to undermine, key Canadian values?
Well, Trudeau in particular, I mean, when you look at all the divisiveness that's gone on in Canada, you look at the invocation of the Emergency Act and trampling horses on people and just his constant attacks on people, it shows that he's really had no interest in politics from day one. It's always been about, I always say, lining his pockets. He's, when you look at the money that was made during COVID and everything that he's done since, it's always for their own agendas, their own policies, which is particularly why I back the convoy, and I think what the convoy did was fantastic. I think it took a big group of people with some influence to finally stand up to the government and kind of push their narrative towards a change. And I think change is coming, and hopefully we see it in other forms of government as we move forward.
We're strong and we're resilient, and we're such beautiful, caring people. And don't give up. Just don't give up. Don't give up hope. And write a book. Oh, yes. It's a thing. It hasn't been released yet, but it will be hopefully next week. I made my mom power read it first. I haven't even finished it yet. I know what's in it, but I wanted my mom to be the first one to read it. I'm really proud of it, and you basically just all listen to it anyways, but I would recommend that you buy it. So, yeah, and it's called Hold the Line, too. Hold the Line, My Story from the Heart of the Freedom Convoy.
This should be our new education system.
I am now joined by the president and co-founder of Canadians for Truth, Joseph Bourgeau. To have Tamara Leach in the house tonight, this, I believe, a sold-out crowd in attendance here for this. What is it like to have someone who's basically become this new Canadian hero in the face of all this adversity, in the face of this attack on Canadian identity from Justin Trudeau?
Well, it's great having Tamara. able to start to speak more freely. Mm-hmm. She was silenced. I had worked with Tamara in Ottawa, mm-hmm. so I got to know Tamara earlier on, met her on the way to Ottawa. So and off and on we would rub shoulders in Ottawa, and it was great working with Tamara. Yeah.
Now you were involved in politics before this. You're obviously a very successful businessman here in Canada. Throughout all those experiences under Justin Trudeau, just how much different is Canada? How much has the identity of Canada changed under his leadership?
Yeah, leadership is a big thing. Obviously, I've been involved in leadership pretty much all of my adult life. And so I know that much can rise or fall on leadership. Mm-hmm. And Justin simply does not have the executive leadership skill, the management skill. He doesn't have the competency skills, and he hasn't developed the character that's required to be able to lead an organization, let alone be the leader of a country. Like Canadians, we're a peace-loving people, but we're also, we fought in two world wars. Our forefathers fought in two world wars. Mm-hmm. And, you know, we're going to stand up for what is right. I think the majority, 80 to 90% of Canadian people or higher, are better than what we have as a prime minister right now.
So I am now joined by Jamie Sallet, a Canadian champion, an Olympian, for many people growing up in the sport of figure skating, very much a hero. I kind of wanted to get your sort of perspective on the time, or at least from the time when you were representing Canada, mm-hmm. to this new version of Canada under Justin Trudeau. Mm-hmm. Just how much do you think the country's changed?
Do you have an hour?
Yeah.
A lot. And I think what we're really seeing, especially for those of us that are speaking out and standing up for freedom and our rights, is that to us, the heroes now are the people that are, you know, that are part of, that were part of the convoy, that are part of speaking up, because it takes a lot of courage and bravery to go through what we're going through, mm-hmm. and have to and be able to speak out about it. And, you know, it's not just the big names that's important. Everybody that is speaking out and standing up to this medical tyranny and the government overreach, they're all heroes to me. Everybody matters in this. And so, you know, as an athlete, I never saw myself as a hero. Heroes to me are people that save people's lives. And I was just doing what I loved, and I was fortunate that I was good at it. But now we are seeing people actually save other people's lives by speaking out and standing up. And for many reasons. I mean, there's people that were sleeping and didn't know that these vaccines were not good. There's people that took them and stopped taking them because they started hearing the people speaking out, talking about it. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. So to me, that's heroic.
Now, and on that notion of heroism, obviously, sort of as an athlete, you give everything. But there might be the risk of embarrassment or a failure. Mm-hmm. But when we're talking about people like Tamara Leach, some of these other people, they faced threats, mm-hmm. Vilification and incarceration. So mm-hmm. what do you make of that willingness to just sacrifice, to do what's right no matter what?
It's funny you're asking this, because Theo and I were talking, we did an interview the other day about this, and it's a mental toughness. We came out of that with it. We have this mental toughness. It's mm-hmm. not quitting. We all see, you know, where we want to be. We know where we want to go. We know what we want to get out of this, and we want freedom, and we want justice too, but we want freedom. We want to be free. And so it's when you have that in your, you know, as a goal or something that you're striving towards, we all feel like we were put here to do this as well. We were, mm-hmm. you know, chosen, however you want to see this. And that it's just about not quitting. And it's as an athlete, that's mental toughness, right? Yeah. None of us got to where we were going without challenges. But like I told everybody when I was skating, I'm not the best figure skater. I'm just the one of them that didn't quit. Mm. And that's what we're seeing with the freedom fighters too. It's the same thing. They're not quitting. And we will, if we have to go down, we will go down standing.
Well, I'll ask you one last question. I'll let you go. I know there's like a sellout crowd here eager to see the show tonight. From your impression, just meeting Tamara Leach, mm-hmm. what's the impression that she has on you?
Well, she's just a regular Canadian girl, an Alberta girl, a Saskatchewan girl. Like, she's just really down to earth, mm-hmm. you know, very heart-centered person that is passionate about helping people, creating awareness, and saving our country.
So a man who needs no introduction, Theo Fleury, in the eyes of many young hockey players within this country, certainly a hero, Stanley Cup champion, representative of this country at the Olympics. In your perspective, from the time you represented this country, whether it be in the NHL, whether it be at the Olympics, flying that flag, how much has Justin Trudeau changed this country?
Well, we are getting very close to becoming a full-blown communist country, right? Where they want it all. They want full control of everything I say, where I go, who I talk to. They also want my body. They want to experiment with transhumanism. And it's been really interesting to follow. But like every communist regime, they always leave little breadcrumbs all over the place, right? Mm-hmm. And, I think when he said that he has an admiration for China, that should have been the first clue as to where we were headed.
Yeah. It's shocking to see this, this notion, like we saw Canadians in Canada on the global scale for a long time as this sort of place that does things somewhat right, mm-hmm. this place that people aspire to, this place that people, including members of my own family, move to in order mm-hmm. to better their life.
Right.
Justin Trudeau has tainted that. That perspective has changed.
Yeah.
But Canadians have a resilient spirit, and one bully doesn't undermine the fundamental identity of a nation. So what do you make of the Freedom Convoy, those people, particularly someone who's here tonight, Tamara Leach, and sort of their brand mm-hmm. of Canadian heroism?
Well, so I believe that every single issue we have in society starts with trauma, okay? Mm-hmm. And, we have a systemic government abuse problem in mm-hmm. this country. The government is abusing its citizens 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. And, I've worked in the field of trauma, mental health, and addiction for the last 15 years. And I believe it's the biggest issue and problem we have in society. And so, I've done every kind of therapy known to mankind mm-hmm. and discovered that the cheapest, most effective kind of therapy is a little thing called group therapy. Mm-hmm. And the Ottawa Convoy was the biggest group therapy session that I've ever witnessed in my whole entire life.
That sort of notion of group therapy.
Yeah.
It's incredible the amount of times I was at protests and I saw someone, it was like an almost universal experience, mm-hmm. bawling and walking with everybody. And every time I'd go to talk to them, they would say, I thought I was alone.
Yeah.
What does it mean? Sorry, go ahead.
And that's what they want, right? That was the purpose of the beginning of COVID, was they closed the churches. They started taking God out of community, mm-hmm. closed the arenas, which are churches, every arena, because that's where you go to get your fill of relationship. And mm-hmm. that's where your kids go to get their, probably their biggest lessons in life, which is being a part of a team. So they closed that and then they locked us down. And as a mental health advocate and a person who has challenges, where's the worst place you can be when you have mental health challenges inside of your own head?
So how critical is it to have sort of heroes like Tamara Leach, individuals who say no to this, despite any, it could be incarceration, it could be anything as Tamara Leach walks by. It could be any, the consequences that they potentially face for taking this down is critical, but because they did, so many people felt empowered.
Yeah. Well, and I was, I've said it many times, it was probably the greatest act of patriotism I'd ever witnessed in my life. And I played in two Olympic Games and won a gold medal. Yeah. And this was like 100x of, the Olympics. Yeah. And, it gave people hope. It inspired people. And Tamara's that person, she just doesn't care, right? And when you stop caring about what they're going to do to you, they have no hold on you anymore. And Jamie and I decided a long time ago that we were going to put our full force behind this because we don't care. Because whether you know it or not, there is a depopulation agenda happening. And so that means there's no more rules. If they want me dead, there's no more rules. And I love to play games when there's no rules, right?
That we can testify to. I know you got a big crowd waiting to see you. Yeah. So I want to thank you so much for your time. Yeah, I really appreciate
it. It's my pleasure. And, you know, we are big fans of Rebel News. And, you know, we all are part of the independent media now. And we all got to stick together and continue to discern the truth. And that's really important, especially right now.
So I am now joined by Tamara Leach, sort of the guest of honor for the evening. Lots of people here extremely interested in your story. I just wanted to ask you, when the events of the Freedom Convoy were sort of unfolding, at the time, did you grasp the sort of scale of it, the historicity of it, as far as like sort of the Canadian identity?
Not at first, obviously, because we didn't really know what to expect. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think I said in my testimony or many times, you know, I thought we'd raise 20 grand maybe, which I felt more than comfortable handling. And then, I mean, within 24 hours, I think we blew past $100,000. So it became very apparent early on that it was turning into something big.
Oh my God. I can't believe this. Oh my God, look at you guys, look at down the street.
When this started, it was turning into something big. People already started vilifying you, vilifying these people. The purported leader of the country, Justin Trudeau, used terms like fringe minority with unacceptable views. When you started to sense that sort of pressure, that pushback, when you started to sense that the powers realized that there was something that they had to tackle here, at any point, did you think you might back off?
No, I don't think we ever really considered backing off. If anything, that made us a little more, steeled our resolve a little bit. And I mean, I've been paying attention to the Liberal government's shenanigans since 2015 and since before, but I totally, I expected it. I knew it was coming. And I even had joked about it, I think, with Chris in a text message about, you know, they're going to pull the race card, you know, and sure enough, they did. So it was.
They were in for a bit of a surprise
they
there.
They were, yeah, that's right.
People, I mean, obviously you probably don't like these terms being thrown around, but a bunch of Olympians included just referred to you as a hero. Someone who, despite the consequences they may face, despite the challenges, despite the vilification, just buckled down and did what had to be done. I know it's bizarre to have someone say, hey, you're the hero, by the way, but what do you say to that?
It wasn't just me. I mean, I can't and won't take credit for all of it. I mean, we had such a good team of people. And to me, the heroes were the truckers, the supporters that were there, the Canadians that stood along the highway, the Canadians that donated money. I mean, it started off as a little group of people with very similar ideas that really wanted to try and make a change and stop what we felt was happening in our country, and just turned into this most beautiful Canadian event. Like, you know, it just showed fundamentally who we are. I've always believed that's who we are. We give, we look after each other, we care about each other. And I think that was one of the biggest aspects, like positive aspects that came out of it, because we've been trying to be pulled apart for so long. You know, the division has been terrible. So I think every Canadian that supported us at least really felt proud and unified and hopeful and happy again, you know?
I think you hit the nail on the head there. Justin Trudeau has very much been sort of picking away at that Canadian legacy, the legacy of peacekeepers, of people who go around the world and proclaim justice, who serve as an example of democracy and transparency. Undeniably, that Canadian legacy has been eroded, but it took Canadians taking a stand like yourself and those who are along with you to say, no, no, this is the Canadian identity. We do stand up for what's right. We do what we need to do. What is needed? What sort of heroism will be needed going forward in fighting against this agenda, this attack on Canadian identity? What has to happen now to preserve Canadian identity?
People need to stop being afraid. You know, we were just talking about this a couple hours ago here.
We have so much support, but we have a lot of silent support because people are afraid to come forward. And that was what the EA did and the freezing of the bank accounts and me and Chris being arrested and Pat too, of course, you know, and Tyson was in jail. And there's still people in jail. Like, I think once people realize that there's nothing to fear and just take a step forward and then vocalize, you know, how they really feel, and even us, I mean, of course, you know, everyone gets afraid at some point, but it's just acknowledging that there's really nothing to be afraid of, especially as we showed last winter. You know, when you all come together, you really make a difference.
Well, a bit of a raucous crowd here as the Tamara Leach event with Theron Fleur and Jamie Sully has just wrapped up. We showed you a couple clips of what was going on in there. The full show, the full conversation that they had is going to be available soon at CanadiansForTruth.ca. So be sure to go check that out if you're interested in watching their full interview. As long as there are brave Canadians willing to sacrifice and stand up against bullies like Justin Trudeau, the core of the Canadian identity will never be erased. In fact, following the Freedom Convoy, we saw people around the world using Canada as an example of resistance and mounting convoys of their own. Due to the unlikely actions of a few unlikely heroes, that maple leaf was once again being flown and regarded as a symbol of strength, perseverance, and freedom. As always, I want to thank you all so much for tuning in. For Rebel News, I'm Adam Sose.
If you want to hear Tamara Leach's story in her own words, go to theconvoybook.com today and pick up your copy of Hold the Line, My Story from the Heart of the Freedom Convoy.